Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to English class. Previous class, I taught tenses. They have given words. We have changed into past tense and past participle. They gave in the past tense. We have written the present tense and past participle. Like that, we have written. And today, I'm going to explain true or false. Okay. Open workbook page number 12. Open your workbook. Page number 12. Bit number 5. Make it first. Okay. What is the fifth bit? True or false? First one, Vinu and Shamu. Were giving employment by the king. So whether it is true or false, let me first one. See this, Vinu and Shamu were given employment by the king. That means Vinu and Shamu get the job by the king. Whether king given job or not? Yes, the king given job to Vinu and Shamu. That means they got employment by the king. So this given statement is true. Okay, write king here. Second one, both of them were very good and equal at work. Yeah, both of them were very good and equal at work. Whether both Shamu and Vinu were working equally? Are they working equally or only one person is working hard and one person is not working? So here, both of them are not working equally. That's why the king increased Shamu's salary but not Vinu's. Why? Because Vinu is not working interestingly. He is not putting interest on the work. Only Shamu is working hard. So that's why only Shamu's salary increased. But Vinu's salary not increased. So the given statement is false. Am I right? Both of them are very good and equal. It was no, they are not equal. So that's why the given statement is false. Next, third. The king increased the salary of Shamu. Just now I explained that the king, after observing 2 months, the king increased the salary of Shamu. So the given statement is true. Fourth sentence. Though Vinu was jealous, the king yes. did not increase his salary. Here. So Bidu was jealous, the king did not increase his salary. So why the king was not increased Bidu's salary? Because he is not working properly like Shyamu, but not because of he is a jealous person. Being a Bidu was jealous person, that's why the king did not increase his salary. No, he is not working properly, that's why he did not increase the salary. So here the statement is talking about Bidu was jealous, that's why the king did not increase his salary. So the given statement is false. Why did he not increase his salary? Because Bidu was not working properly. Am I right? So here the given statement is false. Right. I mean, I think first statement. Fifth one. The zamindar's daughter is being wedded to the high priest then. Okay, look at here. Okay, the zamindar's daughter is being wedded to the head priest, sir. Is the given statement true? As given in the lesson, actually, the zamindar's son, not a daughter, zamindar's son is being wedded to the head priest's daughter. Right? Zamindar's son, not a daughter, Zamindar's son, head priest's daughter is getting married. Okay. But here in the sentence given, the Zamindar's daughter is being wedded by the priest's son. So it's given reverse. Actually, Zamindar's son is getting married with the head priest's daughter. But here, Zamindar's daughter is getting married with the priest's son. Given. So the given statement is false. Shall I write the second sentence? Varun, don't text. Listen. Concentrate on the topic. Don't concentrate on texting to others. Shyamu, return. Shyamu returned and gave the king full information. Information. So here, look at here, the sentence. Shamu returned and gave the king full information. So second time the king called Shamu and he asked that, go and see what is happening outside. So at the time, the Shamu returned and gave full information to the king. So the given statement is true. Shall I write third statement? Third and fourth. Seventh one. Biru had to go four times. Biru had to go. Four times. To give full information. The king. Okay, look at here. Biru had to go four times to give full information to the king. So how many times Biru went outside to give information to the king? According to our lesson, he went three times. First time he went outside and said that the marriage procession is going on. Second time he went and he said that Savita's son is getting married. And third time, he said that Savita's son is getting married with a head priest daughter. That means three answers he has given. That means he went three times outside. Not four times, but in the sentence he went, Biru had to go four times to give full information to the king. That means the given statement is false. Okay, next one. Biru realized his mistake finally. Biru realized his mistake finally. Yes. If Biru realized his mistake finally. Students, don't send messages. Listen carefully. Okay. Biru realized his mistake finally. Yes. Finally, Biru realized his mistake and would do work with more interest. That means the given statement is true. Okay, right. Making fast. Just you have to put options. Don't take too much time. Maybe first have a day. When you raise the board. Next page, page number 6. Fill in the blank choosing correct relative pronouns from the Rakesh. Okay? Fill in the blank. Choosing correct pronoun. Correct. Relative pronouns. Relative pronouns. the brackets. Okay, look at here. The next bit, what we have to do? Fill in the blanks, choosing the correct related pronouns from the brackets. So here some blanks given us. So each blank have three options. From those three options, we have to choose one of the correct relative pronouns which is suitable for the blank. Okay? Already I explained about relative pronouns. Relative pronouns are the pronouns which refers back to a noun. Back to a noun. So relative pronouns shows talking about the nouns which already mentioned in the sentence. Okay? At the starting of the sentence, we have a noun. So after noun, we have a relative pronoun. So which is talking about the noun, that means it refers back to a noun, and also it works to join the two sentences. It works as a conjunction to join two sentences. Such pronoun is a called relative pronoun. I already explained this about the relative pronoun. Okay, maybe you remember that who, which, that. These are the relative pronouns. So shall we write now? Now see the first one, the gentleman. Gentleman dash stands there is our new English teacher. So here options are go. And pose. Now tell me which relative pronoun is suitable for this blank. The gentleman dash stands there is our new English teacher. Okay, so here which relative pronoun we have to use to fill this blank? Whom, or whose? Which is suitable for that? The gentleman who stands there. Not whom stands there and who stands there. Who we should use at the objective place. So we should use who. The gentleman who stands there is our new English teacher. So here, see, this is the relative pronoun which is joining the two sentences. The gentleman who stands there is our new English teacher. So it refers back to a noun. Here it is who. That means who means here? The gentleman. It is deeper. It is showing back to a noun, and also it works as to join the two sentences. That's why we can call it relative pronoun. Okay. I'm writing the 7th and 8th sentences. Go on. Next sentence. The moment. The moment dash is last forever. Wait. Which who? Which and who? These are the options. The moment dash is lost forever. Which relative pronoun is suitable for this blank? Tell me. Where, which, or who? Who we should use for the persons? Okay. So, and where, which we can use for the things or anyone. So now, here we are talking about a moment. The moment dash lasts forever. Who we should not use? Where and which choose from those two? where is lost is not suitable for this, so we should use which. The moment which is lost forever. So here we should use which. Okay. The moment which is lost forever. Next. This is the man. This is the man. There should be met the other day. Met the other day. Here options are who. Who? Okay, so here see these three options given here. This is the man dash we met the other day. So here which relative pronoun we have to use? Who or who or whose? Whose we should use for the thing. Okay, we should not use here. And who means this is the man whom we met the other day. This is the man whom we met other day. Which is suitable here? Tell me. Here, whom is suitable for this man? Okay. This is the man whom we met the other day. Good one. I gave him a rupee. I gave him a rupee. Dash was all I had with me. All I had with me. So here options are which way home? Which way home? Okay, look here. I gave him a rupee. Dash was all I had with me. So which is suitable here? Which was all I had with me? Way was all I had with me? And home was all I had with me. Which is suitable here? Which. I gave him a rupee. Which was all I had with me. So here, which is suitable. Okay. Which was all I had with me. Write which. After writing, remaining and explain. Very fast. I hope you were written first one. Shall I rest? Fifth one, I'm writing here. The book. Dash, I bought yesterday. I bought yesterday. Is very costly. Which with who? One, the book dash I got yesterday is very costly. So which is stood over here? Which way whose? Which black is which answer is stood over here? Which the book which I brought? The book which I got yesterday is very costly. Okay, I hope you understand today's session. And you have 5 lines. Try to fill those 5 lines. If you not understand that, if you are unable to fill those lines, I will explain in the next class. Okay, thank you.